Welcome to Health and Fitness with a new video. Welcome to week 3 of the 2020s challenge. We hope you've been enjoying the workouts so far. Week 03. Day 15. Today's full body dumbbell workout features a new burnout challenge to try plus a brand new trainer to meet. Today's workout is a 30-minute full body strength workout. After you complete your circuits, there's a Tabata burnout at the end. Tabata is a specific type of HIIT training that involves 20 seconds of all-out intense work, followed by 10 seconds of rest, and repeated for a total of 4 minutes. Kick off week 3 of this challenge with heart-pumping new bonus to try. The full-body dumbbell workout below is for day 15. Workout directions. Do each move below for your selected period of work and rest time, option 1, 2, or 3. After your last move, rest for 60 seconds. That's one circuit. Do the entire circuit 3 to 5 times. After your last circuit, try the Tabata. Option 1, 30 seconds of work, 30 seconds of rest. Option 2, 40 seconds of work, 20 seconds of rest. Option 3, 50 seconds of work, 10 seconds of rest. You'll need 2 dumbbells to complete this workout. 1. Squat to diagonal punch, alternating sides. Stand with your feet hip width apart. Holding a dumbbell in each hand with your hands at shoulder height. Do a squat by sending your hips back. Bending both knees and lowering until your thighs are parallel to the floor. As you stand, pivot on your right foot. As you turn slightly and punch your right hand to your upper left, on a diagonal. Bring your right hand back to your right shoulder as you return to your starting position. Now squat again, and this time, punch your left hand to your upper right. Pivoting on your left foot and allowing your body to naturally rotate. Continue to squat and stand to punch, alternating sides each time. 2. Panther plank to high plank. Start on an all fours position with your wrists under your shoulders and knees directly under your hips. Tuck your toes and lift your knees a few inches off the floor, so that you feel your core engage. Your back should be flat, and your weight evenly distributed on your hands and toes. This is your panther plank. From this position, step your right toes back to straighten your leg. Then your left toes back to straighten your leg to come into a high plank position. Pause here. Now step your right foot, then left foot forward again to return to your panther plank position. Continue to step your feet back and forward. Keeping the rest of your body still and your core engaged. 3. Split squat with lateral arm raise. Repeat on each side. Stand with your feet staggered, right foot in front. Left foot behind you, with both legs straight. Make sure your feet are not directly in front of each other, think railroad tracks, not tightrope wire. Engage your core and keep your hips tucked under, avoid arching your low back. And hold a dumbbell in each hand with arms at your sides. Bend both knees to 90 degrees and sink into a lunge. As you lower into your lunge, raise both arms straighter to your sides. At the bottom of your lunge, your arms should be raised to shoulder height. Straighten both knees as you lower your arms to your sides, and return to starting position. Repeat on the same side, keeping feet in a stationary position, for 45 seconds. Then switch the foot that's in front, and repeat on the other side. 4. Superman with arm pull down. Lie face down on the floor with your arms in a goalpost position at your sides. A goalpost position means your arms are raised to shoulder height. And elbows bent to 90 degrees, so your shape roughly resembles a goalpost. From this position, engage your core and upper back, as you lift your shoulders and chest off the floor. Squeeze your glutes and lift your feet off the floor as well. Be mindful to not crunch your low back as you lift. This move is not about flexibility, it's a strength move. From this lifted position, gaze down toward the floor to keep your neck in a neutral position with your spine. Extend both of your hands overhead, so you're flying like Superman. Then engage your shoulders to pull your arms back to their goalpost position. Exhale as you lower everything back to the floor. Make it easier, do not lift your feet off the floor. Focus on lifting just your upper body instead. After your last circuit, try the Tabata. Bonus, Tabata. Do each move below for 20 seconds. Resting 10 seconds between moves. Repeat the circuit 4 times for a total of 4 minutes. 5. Panther plank to high plank, 20 seconds. Start on an all fours position with your wrists under your shoulders and knees directly under your hips. Tuck your toes and lift your knees a few inches off the floor so that you feel your core engage. Your back should be flat and your weight evenly distributed on your hands and toes. This is your panther plank. From this position, step your right toes back to straighten your leg. Then your left toes back to straighten your leg to come into a high plank position. Pause here. Now step your right foot, then left foot forward again to return to your panther plank position. Continue to step your feet back and forward, keeping the rest of your body still and your core engaged. 6. Tuck up, 20 seconds. Lie face up, with legs extended and arms overhead. Engage your core and lift both arms and legs a few inches off the floor to come into a hollow hold position. Now crunch up, bringing your knees to your chest and wrapping your hands lightly around your shins. Keep your core tight to balance on your sits bone. Do not grip your shins or hug your knees in order to achieve balance. Lower to return to hollow hold position and repeat. According to some people who have done workout, the results are impressive and efficient. Do it. And share your opinion with us in the comments below. If you find this video useful, please press like button and share with your friends. Subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get more videos like this. Thank you for watching.